For many years, the Gunson range has been well known for innovative and value for money tools that enable the enthusiastic owner to maintain and service their car to a professional standard without expensive garage equipment. Gunson are particularly well known for their TrackRite wheel alignment range.
Today we'll be looking at the Gunson TrackRite wheel alignment gauge and also some newer recent additions to the Gunson range.
TrackRite is used to make a quick and easy check of the vehicle's wheel alignment. This is also called tracking and measures toe in or toe out of the front wheels. First, make sure the car is on a solid level ground. Then check the tyre pressures are to the manufacturer's specification. Now we will make sure the front wheels are pointing straight ahead and the suspension is settled. The car is moved forward with hands removed from the steering wheel. The TrackRite measures misalignment of the front wheels and the TrackRite scale will show the error. The TrackRite is simply placed in front of one of the front wheels. Set the pointer to zero and drive the car slowly forward over the TrackRite, taking care not to touch the brakes or steering wheel. As the wheel moves over the gauge, any misalignment will be recorded by the pointer. To confirm the reading, repeat the test on the opposite front wheel. If there is no deflection of the pointer after the test, then the wheels are correctly aligned and require no adjustment. To demonstrate, this car has been involved in a front-end accident and the front wheel alignment has been affected. The new Gunson TrackRite laser system provides a quick and easy measurement of the front wheel alignment and is designed to read from the wheel rims. Once again, the tyre pressures are checked and the front wheels are set in the straight ahead position. The TrackRite laser unit is placed in position just forward of the front right hand wheel. We use the wheel gauge as a spacer to set the unit at the correct distance from the edge of the wheel. The wheel gauge is now mounted at a suitable height against the left hand wheel. The gauge must be level, so it is adjusted by moving the angle of the legs against the wheel rim. The laser unit is switched on, and looking under the car, it is adjusted so that the beam hits the centre of the mirror. From the left-hand side, the mirror is adjusted until the reflected beam is level with the calibrated target area on the laser unit on the opposite side. The laser unit is now swivelled until the reflected beam is at zero on the target area. Once it's set to zero, the laser unit must not be moved again. The wheel gauge is now brought around to the right-hand wheel, and again set to level. Once level, the mirror is adjusted until the reflected laser beam is clearly visible on the calibrated target area. This is the final reading, and accurately displays the wheel alignment setting. The Gunson TrackRite camber gauge is a quick and easy way to measure the camber angle of the front wheels. Camber is the angle of the wheel viewed from the front. First, the camber gauge is calibrated by using a spirit level and adjusting the thumb screw on the gauge. Again, make sure the vehicle is on a flat level surface and the tyre pressures have been checked. The gauge is magnetic and is mounted to a flat surface that is 90 degrees to the wheel spindle. If possible, mount the gauge directly onto the wheel hub. The gauge is now adjusted to get the bubble level, and now the camber angle, negative or positive, can be clearly seen on the gauge. If it's not possible to mount the gauge directly to the hub, then use a flat straight bar placed across two flats on the wheel. The camber gauge is placed directly on the straight bar to get the camber angle reading. We will now look at the Gunson 77099, which will measure the camber, caster and KPI with accuracy. The tool is used in conjunction with the Gunson steering turntables, but it can be used on its own for camber readings. Before the steering turntables are positioned, the turntable plates must be locked. Then the turntables are placed under the wheels to be checked. Make sure the wheels are straight and that the turntables are also straight and centred, and carefully lower the vehicle onto the turntables. Then remove the locking pins. A number of useful measurements can now be checked. First, we are going to find out if the steering is centralised. The steering is turned to full lock on the left-hand side. Then the reading in degrees is noted. Now the steering is moved to full right lock, and the reading is checked. The two readings should be the same if the steering is centralised. Now we are going to check the camber using the Gunson 77099 gauge. Again, we make sure the wheels are pointing in the straight ahead position. Then the device is fitted directly to the wheel hub. Take care to level the device by checking the bubble in gauge D. Then read the camber angle in degrees from gauge A. To check the caster angle, we make full use of the steering turntables. Caster is the angle of the steering axis when viewed from the side. First, turn the wheel out to the right by exactly 20 degrees. Fit the device to the centre of the hub again. Level the device by checking the bubble in gauge D. Then set the caster degree gauge to zero by turning the thumb screw underneath. Now turn the wheels back to straight and then in to the left by 20 degrees. Again, level the device and then the caster angle can be read from the caster degree gauge. The same method is used to measure the kingpin inclination. This is the angle of the steering axis when viewed from the front. This time, the angle in degrees is read from the KPI gauge on the device.